Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you.
Hello student. In this presentation, we will take one more topic. Actually, it starts from module 3, but I will consider it as module 4. So that is nothing but flip-flop. So flip-flop or latch is a bistable electronic device. It's a bistable electronic device. It is used to store either 0 or 1 bit. So flip-flops are called as memory element because it will remain set. That is, output in the flip-flop will remain set until something, some action to be done to change it. That's why it is called as a memory element, and sometimes it is also referred as a bistable multivibrator. Bistable means it has got two stable states. One is zero, logical zero, one is logical one. So the basic structure of the flip-flop is, you can see here, the basic structure. This is called as a RS latch or RS flip-flop. So this is constructed by using NOR gate. The truth table for RS, is, you can see here, this is the truth table for RS. That is, when both inputs are zero, output remains in the last state, or you can say no change. When R is 0, set is 1, output is set. Or when R is 1, set is 0, output is reset. And when both are 1, this is question mark, output is forbidden or illegal condition. So you can write, normally RS is RS latch, they are also going to write like SR latch. So when you write like SR, you have to make sure that is, when R is 1, output is 0. When S is 1, output is set. So you can see here, S1 comes here in the second row, here in the third row. So this is set, this is no change, and last one is forbidden. So now, let's see how this works. So, for the reference purpose, I will write here RS or SR. RS 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. That is, here it is 1, 0, no change, and forbidden or illegal. So, now we will take R is 0, S is 0. In order to proceed, we'll take the last state, that is, last state is Q, last state is 0 to this one. When this is 0, output becomes 1. So when here it is 1, this is 1, this becomes a 0. That means last state is 0, you got a 0 for S is 0, R is 0, S is 0. Now, R is 0, S is equal to 1. We will take once again, last state is equal to 0, here it is 0, so here it is 1. It is 1, it is 0, it is 0, and it is 1. When R is 0, S is 1, set. Next, When R is 0, R is 1, S is 0. I will take once again last state is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Sorry, I'm sorry, 1. 1, this is 1, this is 0. Let me repeat this one. When R is 0, sorry, R is 1, S is 0. R is 1, S is 0. I will take this is 0. So this becomes 0. Output is equal to 1. And this 1 moves here. 1 and 0. That is reset. Fourth condition is when both are 1, you will not get actual output. That is, when both are 1, when this is also 1, this is also 1, I will take last state is equal to 0. Last state is 0. I will take 0. This is 1, this is 0. So this is 0. This is 1. This is 0. So when Q bar is 0, you should get Q is equal to 1. Or when this is 0, you should get this is equal to 1. That we are not getting. That means that it violates the rules of Boolean logic. That is, when Q is equal to 0, Q bar is 1. When Q bar is 0, Q is equal to 1. So that's why it is called as illegal condition or forbidden condition. Now, same flip-flop you can construct by using NAND gates. When you construct this one by using NAND gate, you see here, when you construct by using NAND gate, so let us take this is S and this is R. When you construct this by using NAND gate, so you will get a truth table like this. 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. That is, you will get a reverse of RS. Reverse of RS latch. So in order to overcome this one, what you are doing is here, you are adding extra NAND gate, you can see here. So when you add extra NAND gate, here S, here it becomes S bar R bar. So earlier case, it was called as S bar R bar latch. But when you connect NAND gate, then you will get actual output. So let me repeat once again. So when you use NAND gate, the output you will get something like this. This is the reverse of NOR gate latch. So this one is called as R bar S bar latch. In order to overcome this one, we are using two extra NAND gates here. You can see these are the two extra NAND gates. And when you use these two extra NAND gates, you will get the actual output. So this is a construction of SR or RS latch by using NAND and NOR. Now, clocked RS flip-flop. What do you mean by clocked RS flip-flop? Or gate RS flip-flop? See, The first category of the flip-flop, what we saw just now, is called as a transparent latch. Whatever the input you give, you will get the output based on the input. Second one is called a semi-transparent. In semi-transparent, depending on the one more signal, that is enable signal, you will get the output. When the enable is high, you will get the output. When enable is low, you will not get output. Third one is called as sequential type, where output is sequenced with the clock signal. So now we'll see. Clocked or gated flip-flop, here we are using enabled signal. So in the diagram you can see, we are using enable signal here. When the enable is high, you will get the output. When enable is low, you will not get the output. That you can see here. This one is the symbol, and when enable is high, you will get, it works like SR. Always when you write the output of the truth table, flip-flop, you have to write Qn plus 1. This is the next state. Always this indicates the next state. So Qn indicates the last state. This should be Qn plus 1. And here, with respect to flip-flops, so we are not calling this is a truth table. We are calling this is something like a transition table. Here the output is not only depends on the just input. Output depends on the fast history. Output depends on the previous output and the present input and previous output or previous input. So that's why it is called as a transition table. So you can see here, when the enable signal is 1, it works like SR. When the enable is 0, it will not work like SR. It will remain in the last state. SR is XX and it will remain in the last state. Now, clocked D. Now, what is the disadvantage of RS flip-flop? The disadvantage of RS flip-flop is, here we need 2 signals. To set the flip-flop, we need, I have to make S is equal to 1. To reset the flip-flop, I have to make R is equal to 1. When you make R is equal to 1, Q you will get 0. Here, when you make S is equal to 1, you will get Q is equal to 1. So, this becomes some type of problem for serial data transmission, where the data is transmitted 1 bit at a time. One bit in the form of bits. So in order to avoid this one, and also in SR, when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, output is equal to forbidden. To avoid this one, we have one more flip-flop that is called as a D, that is called as a data. So to construct data flip-flop, what we are doing is, we are connecting inverter between S and R. That means to set, when D is equal to 1, the flip-flop is set because here it becomes 0. When D is equal to 0, the flip-flop is reset. So this is the diagram for D. D we are constructing using SR only. So IEEE symbol for D with the enable signal and logical symbol. And the truth table, when the truth table is, when it is enable is 0, it will not work, it will maintain the last state. When the enable is 1, whatever data is present at the input, data will be moved to the output. That is called as a that is the truth table for a D flip-flop. Now, edge triggered. This is something called as
sequential. First one what we saw, transparent, semi-transparent, and sequential category. That is, here the output is sequenced with the clock signal. That's why it is called edge-triggered flip-flop. Here we are giving clock pulse to the clock pulse to the here clock pulse is given to PT pulse forming circuit, and the circuit, this circuit is sensitive to the either positive edge of the pulse or the negative edge of the pulse. Based on that you will get the output, and you can see here this is positive edge triggered D flip flop. Here you see this is positive edge indicates, clock indicates positive edge, and based on the input output will appear. So please remember the symbol is to represent positive edge triggered flip flop is something like this. So this is indicates the positive edge triggered, this is indicate the negative edge triggered. Negative edge triggers are represented by triangle arrow mark with the bubble. Positive edge triggered are represented with the arrow mark. Next one is edge triggered RS. We'll see edge triggered RS. Edge triggered RS. In edge triggered RS also there are positive edge triggered RS and a negative edge triggered RS. It is the circuit diagram you can see here. This indicates the circuit diagram. Very simple. Here clock is given to pulse forming circuit. It will generate either positive edge triggered or negative edge triggered. This case is the positive edge triggered. So this is the output. Positive edge triggered and output remains same. Only the difference between this and transparent is in transparent whenever you give the output whenever input changes output changes, but here during the positive edge triggered only output changes. Let's check this one. This is the clock signal. This is the positive edge triggered, positive edge of the clock. Now we'll see at the T0 R is 0, S is 0, output is 0. At T1 R is S is 1, that means output will be set till next edge triggered. At this point R is 1, that means output is reset till next edge triggered. So in this way this will work. So my dear students, before proceeding, one more circuit diagram you have to see here. Waveform of clogged RS, that is clogged RS. Here we are giving enable signal. So whenever the enable signal is high, it works. You can see here this enable signal is high here at T1 and T2. So at T1, what is R? R is 0, S is 1. So S output goes high. At T2, you can see T2 occurs somewhere here. At this stage R is 0, S is 1, that means output remains 1 till T3. Even though here R goes up, the value of R goes high, it will not change, because during this period enable is low. Now when the enable becomes high once again at T3, R is 1, S is 0, that means it will reset. At T4, S is 1,
T4, S3 is 1. So output is 1 till T5. At T5, both R and S is 0. When R and S is 0, output will be last 8. What is the last 8? That is 1. So till T6, it is 1. T6, once again, R and S is 0. So till T7, it is 1. T7, once again, R and S is 0. So till T8, it is 1. In this way, it works. So in the exam, they may ask, draw the circuit diagram of a 4-bit latch. 4-bit latch constructed by using D flip-flop or data latch. So see here, in the exam, they may ask data latches. Data latches means by using D flip-flop. So how to construct 4-bit? So it is very simple. Use 4 flip-flops of D. Input is D0, D1, D2, D3. Output is Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. And all are connected with the enable signal. This is enable signal or clock. So when you give the clock, output input moves to the output. So suppose input is 0100, when you give the clock, input moves to the output. Otherwise, output will remain in the last state. So that is the latch. So similarly, they may ask you to draw 8-bit. Then that time you need 8 latches of D flip-flop. So negative edge triggered RS. Negative edge triggered RS, you can see here. This represents the negative edge triggered RS, and this is a trip table or transition table. So we'll see negative edge triggered RS here diagram in the exam. If you write like this, it is better. So during the negative edge triggered here, this is the negative edge points. S is 0, R is 0, Q is 0. Here, S is 1. That means this becomes 1. Till next negative edge triggered. At this point, S is 0. This becomes 0. Till next edge triggered. At this point, it is 1. Till next edge triggered. At this point, both are 0. Both are 0 means last 8. So that is the output. Hello student, in this presentation we will see the application of on D flip-flop. Here you can see in the exam they may ask how D flip-flop can construct a D flip-flop with the preset and clear function. So here you can see the circuit diagram of D flip-flop with preset and clear function and with the application. Application in the sense like here we are using reset button. When reset button is pressed, then D becomes 1. And during the positive edge of the clock, output becomes 1. And this output remains 1 as long as reset button is held closed. When you release the reset button, depending on the value of D, during the first edge of the PT, output changes. Other than that, this is also called as asynchronous preset and clear, because it has got two additional input, preset and clear. Based on the preset and clear, you can set the flip-flop or you can clear the flip-flop. This is asynchronous. This is not synchronous with the clock. That's why it is called as preset and clear are called as asynchronous input here, because they activate the flip-flops independently. So now next one is edge triggered JK flip-flops. So JK flip-flops, the diagram of the JK flip-flops, you can see here. So JK flip-flop is used to overcome the disadvantage of RS. That is, in RS, both are 1, then output is when both R and S is 1, output will forbidden. But that is overcome by using JK. How it is possible? This is possible because in JK, what we are doing is, in JK, we are connecting Q bar output of output to the input and Q output as a feedback to the input of other AND gate. We are connecting one output, that is complement output, to the one of the AND gate where J is connected, and we are connecting other output to the, we are connecting other output to the other AND gate where K is connected. So this will overcome the disadvantage. So you can see this is edge triggered one. It is represented here. When J is 0, K is 0, no change. When J is 0, K is 1, reset. When J is 1 and K is 0, set. And when both are 1, you will get toggle. So exam, you need to explain this one, bit additional information. So here you can see, these are the important points from the exam purpose. And the symbol for edge triggered, symbol with negative edge triggered, symbol with clear signal, active low clear signal. So here you can see negative edge triggered with the active low preset and clear. Here only clear is used, but it is a negative edge triggered. So next one is fifth law of timing. What do you mean by the timing? You see, practically, in the sequential circuit, when you give the output, input, output will not immediately change. When you give the input, output will not immediately change because each gate has its own propagation delay. So output will take some time to change. So for the flip-flop, so here 3 points we need to consider. One is called as propagation delay or propagation delay. Second one is called as setup time. Third one is called as old time. Third one is called as old time. So this one you have to see here. So let me explain. You can see here, my dear students, this is the clock signal. Now, setup time is the time during which input should present before the clock arrives. Suppose at T2 clock arrives, you take T2 clock arrives, then input present at starting from T1, that is called a setup time. Old time is the minimum amount of time after the clock arrives, the input should present. That is called as old time. See here, this time, the input should remain 1 year, otherwise you will not get output. Here clock starts after this amount of time, the input should remain 1. That is called as old time. Last one is the processing. You can see here, output is shifted. See, you will not get immediately output here. Output is shifted. See, this is called as a processing delay. Because of the processing delay, output is shifted. Not exactly you will get the output at this edge of the clock. So, parameters you need to remember. So now JK master slave flip flops. So in order to overcome the disadvantage of JK, this one RS, we are using JK. In JK also we combine JK with the master and slave. So because when you use only single flip flop JK, the output at the condition J is equal to 1, K is equal to 1 will change twice during the single clock. That is called as race around condition. In order to avoid race around condition, we are using one more flip-flop, that is called as a slave. So here in the diagram you can see
This is the master and this is a slave. Master change, works during the positive cycle and passes the output as input to the slave. And slave copy the action of the master and works during the negative cycle. So master works during the positive cycle and slave works during the negative cycle. Now, here you can see the symbol. This is the symbol of JK master slave. So here JK clock, and this is the symbol indicates output Q is the output only when the data is processed by both master and slave. That means Q will not change its state until slave works during the negative edge of the clock. Q doesn't change its state until slave works during the negative edge of the clock. That's why that is called as postponed output. That is represented by like this. And you can see here, this is the truth table. Switch contact bound circuits. So in the digital system, we use most of the time in digital system you use most of the time mechanical contacts. So these mechanical contacts are actioned by or work based on the arm movement or spring action. So, for example, you take the switch which we use in the lab. So here, let me explain. When the switch is open position, when the switch is in open position, output is equal to 1. When switch is closed, output is 0. See, when the switch is open, output at the voltage A is equal to 1. When switch is closed, it is 0. But when switch is closed, it will not close properly. It will bounce us from up and down. That is 1 and 0. This is called as a bouncing effect. This will disturb the output of the digital system. How to overcome this one? To overcome this one, we are using RS latches. We are using the properties of the RS latches. So you can see here the circuit. So you can see the circuit here. When switch is moved from this to this position, output becomes, initially output is 1 minute. Yeah, when initially the switch contact is here, when the switch moves, when the switch contact moves from low to high, you will observe the bouncing effect. I mean, switch observe the bouncing effect. Here you can see it takes several high and low. Now R is low. During the first I of this S, output is set to 1 because S is 1 and R is 0. Now, because of bouncing, it becomes 0, S becomes 0 and R is already 0. So, here when S is 1, R is 0, Q is 1. But when S is 0, R is 0, it remains in the last state, that is Q is 1. Once again, when switch bounces back to 1 here, that means S becomes 1, R becomes, R is 0. Anyway, it is in the 1 state only. So output remains, output will not change, output remains in the 1.
So this is called as a debouncing circuit of a debouncing circuit or a simple RS latch. How it can be used as a debounce circuit? So now characteristics equation of the various flip-flops. So what is characteristics equation? Characteristics equations of flip-flops are used to analyze the circuit made by them. Here the output is expressed as the function of present output and input to the flip-flops. So my dear students, you can see your truth table. You see your truth table. This is SR and this is QN and this is next output. So next output depends on Q as a function of QN and SR. So when you take three variable, this three variable can take eight combinations. Three variables can take eight combinations. So now we will take the group. This is one group, this is the second group, this is the third group, and this is the fourth group. When SR is 0, what our truth table says, RS latch, SR is 0, last state. So when last state is 0, present state is 0. Last state is 1, present state is also 1. That means present state will maintain the last state. When SR is equal to 0, 1, it will be reset. So here you can see output is reset. Present state, this is the last state, output is reset. When SR is equal to 1, S is 1, output is set. If the last state is 0, output is 1. If the last state is 1, output is 1. When SR is equal to 1, 1, output is toggle. So when you map this one using our K-map, then expression Qn plus 1 is nothing but this one. So you can say the output is nothing but the function of the flip-flop's input and last state. Similarly, for the D diagram, you can see D can take value 0 and 1, present input, last input and the next input. So last in, see here, whatever the value is there, same value will be moved to the output. So you can solve this one and you will get Qn plus 1 is equal to D. Next one is T. T is called as a toggle, flip-flop. The difference between T and JK is T is toggle when input is 1. When input is 0, output remains last state. When input is 1, output will toggle. You can see here T input, it can take the value 0011. So this is the two variable this one truth table. Qn depends on input and last state 0001101. When T is 0, output is last state. When T is 0, output is last state. Here 1, output is 1. Here our last state is 0, output is 0. When T is 1, you see last state is 0, it will toggle, output is toggle. When T is 1, last state is 1, output is toggle, 0. If you solve this one, you will get this expression. This is a exclusive NOR. Exclusive OR gate. Next one. Next one is JK. So JK, you can see here, very very important question from the exam point of view. Characteristics characteristics equations is used to analyze the circuit made by the latches. So here you can see JK also. So you have to draw JK in this way only. So three variable you take. This is the last data and this is the next data. So then make the group of JK 0, 1, JK 1, JK 1 0 and JK 1 1. And you see the truth table JK. See JK truth table is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. This 0, last data, set and toggle. I'm sorry. Last 8, reset, set and toggle. Now you see here, JK 00. Now this works, last 8. So what is the last 8 here? 0. This is the present state. What is the last 8? 1. This is the present state. When JK is 0, 1, reset. So irrespective of this one, output is 0. What is the JK 1, 0? Set, irrespective of last data, output is 1. This is toggle. Last data is 0, output is 1. Last data is 1, output is 0. So these are the characteristics equation. These are the characteristics equation of latches, four type of flip-flops. So from the exam point of view, very important. Next one is flip-flop as a finite state machines. So this finite state machine is a better alternative to the truth table in understanding the progress of sequential circuits. So here you can see the finite state for it has got now RS, you will take SR, it has got only two state, either 0 or 1, either 0 or 1. So now when SR is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1, it will remain in 0 state only. We'll take the SR truth table 0, 0. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. This is last state, this is 0, this is 1, this is toggle, right? Now you take 0 state. To get the 0 state, to remain in 0 state, SR should be this one. So this one is represented here. So to move to the 1 state, either it should be 1 0. When SR is 1 0, it will move to the 1 state and remain in 1 state. To remain in 1 state, it should be 1 0 or 0 0. 0 0 always gives last state. Imagine last state is 1. When you give the value of SR 0 0, it will remain in last state. So to move to 0 state, once again, from here 1, it should be 0, 1. So, please remember here, to remain in 0 state, SR should be 0001. To remain in 1, SR can be 0010. To move from 0 to 1, 10, SR should be 10 or 01. To move from 1 to 0, 01. 0 to 1, 10. Similarly, D. As long as D is 0, it will remain in 0 state. As long as 1, it will remain in 1 state. To move between 0 to 1, D should be 1 or D should be 0. JK. You will take JK truth table 0001 1011. Here last 8, 0, 1 and toggle. Now, it will be in 0 state when SR is 0, JK 00 or 01. It will be 1 state when 00 and 10. It will move from either 1 to 0 or 0 to 1 during this condition. Similarly, T. So, this is the final state machine for all the flip-flops. And from this, we can draw the excitation table. So, you can see here, excitation table is nothing but Qn is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Here, we will use output and from output, we will proceed towards input. So, this is the present state, this is the next state. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, 0, 0. Present state is 0, next state is 0. The possible causes are of SR are 0 and X. How this is possible? You see here. For this, we will take you to the, once again, our FSM. The present state is 0, next state is 0, also 0. Possible only when SR is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1. That means I can write 0, X. The present state is 0, next state is 1. The present state is 0, next state is 1, possible when SR is equal to 1, 0. The present state is 1, next state is 0, possible SR is 0, 1. And present state is 1, 1, possible XR is equal to X, 0. So, for this you have to refer our FSM. So, here also you can see in JK, you will get 0X, 1X, X1 and X0 and D and T. This is our excitation table. So you have to remember this one to solve synthesis problem. So SGL implementation in flip-flops. So here you can see D latch. So input is D and enable, output is Q. So always at enable or D. If enable is enable is 1, output is D, otherwise 0. Now here by using always statement other way. This is D, this is SR. For SR, use the characteristics equation. The characteristics equation you can write like this. If enable is 1, Q is equal to S or R, that is S plus R bar Q. That is, you got it from characteristics equation and module. Next. So next one is edge triggered. Positive edge triggered, negative edge triggered. You can see here. This is the positive edge triggered. and this is the negative edge triggered, always during the negative edge. This is positive edge or negative edge or clear, negative edge of the clear. So here you have to give the condition, if clear signal is given, Q is equal to 0, otherwise Q is D for D type of positive edge triggered with clear. If active low clear is given, output is equal to 0. Out represent 1 bit is 0. This is in this format. Otherwise, 1 bit is 1. That is Q is D. 1 bit is, that is the bit is, output is D. D may be 0 or 1. So next one. Write the Verilog code for to convert D to SR flip-flop. So for that, I am using here SR. SR flip-flop contains SR clock Q and wire is a DSR. DSR is nothing but characteristic equation, I got this one. From the characteristic equation, I got this one. Then I will call D flip-flop as a function. D flip-flop. Inputs are DSR, C and Q. Separately, I am writing D flip-flop, code for D flip-flop. Always at the negative edge, Q is equal to D. That I am calling here. In the SR, you know, SR is constructed, you know, from the characteristics equation, this is the characteristics equation for SR and this is the characteristic equation for Q. That I am, sorry, D, that I am calling here.